Welcome to Department of Electronics and Telecommunication at Vidyalankar Institute of Technology. In this department, we have taken this new initiative to start our own YouTube channel. In this YouTube channel, we are going to upload all our experiments video, value-added course video, or any other important videos. This material will be available to all the students in Mumbai University, and this material will help students to enhance their learning, not just in their classroom, but even outside the classroom. I hope that everyone will like this our effort, and in case of any query, comments, anything, they can put it in comment box. Thank you.
LSI lab, today we will be looking into XOR operation. Here we can see the XOR equation as A B bar plus A bar B, but we know that the output of CMOS is always inverted. That's why we will invert this equation twice so as to get Y itself. So the final equation that we would be using for CMOS implementation is this. Now let's look into the CMOS implementation. Here we can see that A and B bar are in, A bar and B are in series with each other, which is in parallel with A and B bar according to that table of reference. In NMOS, we can see that A bar and B are in parallel to each other, which is in series with A and B bar. Now let's look into the stick diagram of this CMOS.
Look into the stick diagram of XOR. As we have seen the CMOS implementation of XOR, here we have to note that the source of every PMOS is connected to VDD and the source of every NMOS is connected to the ground. A loop is required for making the stick diagram implementation such that the implementation of the inputs of PMOS and the inputs of NMOS is matched. Now let us consider the loop of A bar, B, B bar and A. Similar loop would be considered for NMOS, A bar B, B bar A. Accordingly, we can see that the same loop is applied for using the polysilicons, A bar, B, B bar and A. Source and drain are given names of S1, D1 and corresponding names to the inputs of PMOS and NMOS. Now here we can see that S1 and S2 is connected to VDD. Similarly, here S1 and S2 is connected to VDD. S7 and S8 is connected to ground. S7 and S8 is connected to ground. Now here we can also see that D3 and D4 is connected to D5 and D6 through which the output is obtained. So D3 and D4 is connected to each other, which is in turn connected to D5 and D6, and here we obtain the output. Our next connection that we'll look into is S5 and S6. Here we can see that S5 is connected with S6, which is connected with D7 and D8. Now S6 and D8 is connected. Only connection left is D7 and D8, which is connected using this metal. So the output obtained would be from here, and the N well would be above the output in which the PMOS lies. Now let's look into the implementation in microvent. Thank you.
Now let us look into the layout implementation of XOR. Here we can see that the layout is implemented similar to the stick diagram that we just looked into. The upper metal is used for VCC. The lower metal is used for ground. Yellow color is used for P diffusion, whereas green color is used for N diffusion. Four polysilicons, A bar, B, B bar and A are used with various metal contacts for the contacts of metal with the two diffusions and with VCC and with ground. Now let us give the polysilicons a clock signal according to the signals, according to the inputs of it. We know that this polysilicon is referred to as A bar, whereas this polysilicon is referred as A. Adding a clock to this polysilicon, let us name it as A. Assign. This polysilicon is nothing but A bar. So let us assign this as A bar. For this polysilicon, this would be the negation of A. So this can be done simply by applying the clock and giving negation of the last clock from here. Assign. Now from the stick diagram, we can see that this is B and this is B bar. Same negation to this polysilicon of this polysilicon can be given. Let us give the clocks. This would be B. And this would be B bar. Negation of the last clock. Assign. Now let us give VCC and ground to the metals. VCC and ground. A VCC is also given in the NPU. And for the output, we use the output signal. Output in this. Label name would be Y. Now to check whether there are any issues with the lambda rules, we have this, a design rule checker. Here we can see that there is the metal width is less than 3 lambda. So to change it, we can simply extend the metal. Let us check it again. Now we can see that no design rule error is there. So this is fine for the output, final output. Now let's look into the waveforms. So this is all about XOR regarding its stick diagram, layout diagram, and its implementation in the microwave. Thank you.